is a racist.
I think he is a racist.
Kerry, what the president said is not something that should be brushed off. Why haven't we heard from more GOP lawmakers on these comments? Not even Kevin McCarthy, who was standing right next to the president yesterday when the president was forced to address these comments. He was in that room. That would have been a perfect opportunity for him to say, if these comments that were reported were not true, to say so, wouldn't it?
Sure. Well, I haven't seen directly what he has said or not said.
He hasn't said anything.
Sure. And again, I think that the president, we know, he is an individual who was elected not because of his flowery language, not because he is a diplomat. He is someone who said, you know what, things are out of control in this country. We need to change a different course. I think that, you know, rather than trying to say, oh, the president needs to speak a certain way, which I personally would love for him to be more diplomatic. I would love for him to be more reconciling. Even if he won't, that's our responsibility as a country. We are the people, we are the leaders, as even Barack Obama said, we should be the change that we want to see in the world. And I urge the president to use Martin Luther King Day as a time for him to set the reset button. He could be like Ronald Reagan. What Ronald Reagan did was he grew his electoral margin, but he did that by using language that is unifying. So absolutely, I would love to see more unifying language coming from the Republican leadership. I'd love to see it coming from the president. But I do think it is also important to look again at the policies and see how the lives of African Americans have been improved. I know Nancy Pelosi said that $1,000, you know, given to people because of the tax reform bill, she said that that was, you know, crumbs. She said it was crumbs. But that $1,000 for working families working at Walmart, that's a lot of money. And for African Americans who have jobs that didn't have jobs before, that's meaningful. Okay, it's not crumbs.
Let me go ahead. This nonsense that's going on out here from Kerry. Kerry, this is ridiculous. The unemployment rate for African Americans was cut in half from 16.8% to 7.8% under Barack Obama, the president of the United States who preceded Donald Trump.
Let me just finish this for a second
because Donald Trump last year was saying, a year before last, when he was running for office, said those numbers were fake and phony. He said that the unemployment rate was actually in the 40% range for African Americans. He lied about the African American unemployment rate, and then as soon as he got in office, he inherited the declining unemployment numbers, and he took credit for what President Obama did. That's disgusting. It's abhorrent. And the president should apologize to President Obama not only for the lies about the birth certificate, but about the lies about the African-American community that he continues to spread. And you, Kerry, to sit here and defend this when you should know, because you're a smart person who studied the statistics, you should know that the president did nothing, has not lifted a finger to help the African-American community. He's been the most divisive president we've seen in our lifetime for African-American people. And I don't want to hear any nonsense about taking credit for things that President Obama did unless he acknowledges that President Obama had some role in doing that. That's what's so indefensible.
With all due respect, labor force participation rate is up for African Americans, and that was the criticism that Trump leveled, was that labor force participation among African Americans and all Americans under Obama's term had been declining, and that's a fact. You can go to the bank with
that. The change in the labor force participation rate, first of all, it changes, it's very minuscule over the past year. We're talking about less than 1 point, and we're also talking about a statistically insignificant difference because of the variance with a small sample size for African Americans. But the reality is the unemployment rate has been going down consistently, and it's been a pattern that started in 2010. It started under President Obama. So don't try to take credit for something that Donald Trump has done nothing to do.
Okay, got to leave it there, guys. We're out of time, but thank you both for sharing your thoughts, making your points. Obviously, a very passionate issue for many. Coming up, the false alarm.